Oscar Rothomio, aged 32 and a resident of Wampewa Nangabo village, queues up to have his ears checked. Rothomio recalls that his ear health was started with itching. He later resorted to cleaning the ears with matches, in addition to applying cooking oil, but all in vain. His ear health deteriorated completely until today he had to seek treatment during a medical camp organized by Mulago Paramedical School as part of the activities to mark the World Hearing Day. Here, Rothomio shares his story.
2 weeks back, felt my ears were always itching, so I decided to use matchbox sticks to clean my ears every day. Then until it reached a point I couldn't hear well. I would feel some pain, like my ear is kind of swollen, like that. So I told my family member about it, and it was actually my dad, but he had his eardrops. He assisted me with it, but it tried, but it was too little.
Enid Mugume Ahimsiwe, a health tutor who doubles as an ear, nose and throat specialist at Mulago Paramedical School, explains what hearing loss is and how it comes about.
The word hearing loss, in other words, in a medical term, we can call it hearing impairment. This is when a person, could be a child, could be an adult, and has had problems in perceiving, in getting sounds better. This is when a person cannot be able to hear well, or a person can permanently fail to hear. He doesn't hear anything. And there are causes. Some of these causes can start when the mother is pregnant. During pregnancy, sometimes others do self-medication, which can be toxic to the young baby, the growing baby in the uterus. And this will destroy the hearing as the embryo grows. There is a problem of drug abuse. There is a problem of cutty and marijuana. It has also caused.
Ahimsiwe further explains how noise originating from loud music or a factory can cause hearing impairments.
When you are given a job, you just say thank you, you go telling people I've gotten a job, but you don't count risks and uncertainties. Sometimes you go to work in a factory, you reach there, the machines are 24/7, you are exposed to that sound. Eventually, with time, you will be saying, oh, I can't hear, pardon. And it is difficult to realize, not until people would tell you.
When it comes to noise, there are recommended levels for residential, commercial and factory or industrial areas.
The level of noise at our home are supposed to be, like, residential noise level supposed to be at 45 at night, then 50 during day. In town setting, urban setting, the noise level should be at 65, at night should be at 60. Then at factory or industrial areas, the noise level should be at 80 and 75 during the night time.
Not well-managed non-communicable diseases such as hypertension, trauma resulting from head accidents or domestic violence are the other culprits of hearing loss, as Ahimsiwe father explains.
That nerve that actually takes the message to the brain. So also need to talk about those diseases and talk about and tell our people what those high blood pressures can cause. And we're also looking at trauma, which is very common, accidents, most especially head accidents. You find somebody gets a head accident, immediately the person loses the hearing.
Ahimsiwe explains that pushing objects in the inner ear, accumulation of wax as well as infections can cause permanent hearing loss.
Especially we shall find children push foreign bodies in their ears. and you find it causes discomfort in hearing and the person not be able to hear well. Sometimes we have wax, and we call it wax impaction, which in Luganda we call it mvumbo. It can also get impacted within the canal here, and it causes a temporary hearing loss. But when it comes to the middle ear, it's where I talked of, where mothers say they are breastfeeding and the breast milk is entering there. No, this is an infection that usually occurs in the middle ear, and most especially in children under 5, those school nursery going children, because they mix up with others always.
While highlighting the telltale signs of hearing loss, Ahimsiwe says children are the most affected.
I will start with the most vulnerable people, and these are the children. You will find a child has gone to school and has a hearing problem, and the parents have not identified. One is having a hearing impairment. They normally present with what we call tinnitus, that noise in the ear. It will be there and it will disturb this person. And how do you see this person also? The person will always be turning the normal ear to you. If one ear is affected and there is one normal ear, you will find the person turning the other ear, or the person will fix his eyes on your face because he wants to deep read, wants to see what you see.
Once a hearing loss sets in, managing it starts with screening, as Ahimsiwe explains. Sometimes hearing aids come in handy to alleviate the problem. The only challenge is that they are very costly, yet they are not available in government health facilities.
When the person has got a temporary type of hearing loss, maybe caused by foreign body, maybe caused by an infection, maybe caused by wax, okay? There are some procedures that we do. The one of infection will be treated. The one who has wax, we have a procedure which we call in our language ear syringing. It is one ear. When there are two ears, it is called bilateral, because both ears are affected. So if you had to use this hearing aid, this sample is called behind the ear. You fix it behind the ear. And then, but the challenge with these hearing aids that you're seeing here is that government has not provided these services. They are only done in private.
Hearing impairment or loss affects individuals, families and communities, hence the need to care.
And also we have other marriages, because they have dropped from school and they have an option. There is an issue of unemployment, or they even chase you away from employment because you are now deaf. In recruiting children in schools, people with hearing impairment are always neglected.
The World Hearing Loss Day today was commemorated under the theme Changing Mindsets. Let us make ears and hearing care a reality for all. The national celebrations were held in Gulu District. Story compiled by Agnes Chotalengerire for the news.